And now an announcement from the 43rd President of the United States, George W. Bush.
This is an important day. I've made a big decision. I'm entering the race for President of the United States of America. The field of Republicans out there is so messed up, I figured it makes you miss me, doesn't it? Yeah. And that's saying a lot. I've already got my campaign song. Ready or not, here I come. You can't hide. I'm gonna find you and make you love me. That's a little something from the Fugees. I'm telling you, I can beat these guys. Here, let's take a look at some of the front runners. Dr. Ben Carson. I can barely hear him when he talks. I'll tell you something, that's not gonna work when you have to go to China or Azerbaijan, where you have to talk loudly so they will understand. Not to mention, he's some kind of brain surgeon. And I got news for him. Running the country is not brain surgery. Okay? No. Trust me, I know. Next, Carly Fiorina. I like Carly. She's got guts. She got fired from her job. She got her butt kicked in a Senate race. She's not qualified in any way to be president. In many ways, she reminds me of me. But she isn't me. I am me. Next. Cruz and Rubio. Rubio and Cruz. Sounds like a Miami law firm. If you've been injured on the job, call Rubio and Cruz. These two guys, the sons of immigrants, hate immigrants. I, for one, like the Mexican people. They are my amigos. Tex-Mex is my favorite kind of food. I enjoy the slow roasted carnitas at Chevy's. Laura always orders the Baja sampler with the blue crab enchiladas. And the way I see it, unless your name is Running Bear or Chief Two Rivers, we're all anchor babies. That's something to think about. Yeah. And then you got this knucklehead. With the hair. And the 100-foot wall. Bring that picture back. I tell you something, whenever I get in a bad mood, I just picture his big, fat, orange Oompa Loompa face, and I just piss my pants. And now he says he wants to keep all the Muslims out. Yeah, great idea. That's impossible to implement and not what this country is about. Heck, that's like saying, let's keep all the leprechauns out. We tried tiny leprechaun internment camps in the late 1920s. And as you all know, it totally backfired. Leprechaun relations have never recovered since. That's why they are so hard to find. I'm serious, when was the last time you saw a leprechaun? I say no thanks to Donald Trump. Next, Jeb. Oh boy, poor Jeb. You gotta admit, it's a pretty good plot twist that I turned out to be the smart one. Of course, I wish you would have asked me about the exclamation point on the end of his name. Look, I don't like the taste of broccoli, but it doesn't get any tastier if you call it broccoli. He doesn't stand a chance in this field, and He's an insider who knows how to govern. The Republican voters don't want that. They want someone who is cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs. But running a government is kind of like driving a school bus. You don't want a crazy person driving that bus. You want a simple, underachieving, not very educated, but reliable guy behind that wheel. Someone with a steady hand who will be on time and get into one or two, but no more than four accidents a year. You already know that someone, and that someone is me. I'll see you in the White House. And live from New York, it's Saturday night.
Thanks for watching, and remember to subscribe. Now it's laser time.